Hi everyone, Carolina here from creations-handmade. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make your own ticket strips to decorate your projects and embellishments. And I also want to share with you some embellishments that I've been making. I used several different punches and I clustered different shapes together. I also used my glitter cardstock, and I'm going to put a link to my tutorial on how to make your own glitter cardstock. It's super easy and the result is awesome. So if you want to check it out, click on the link below. On this cute prize ribbon, I'm also using cork. I like mixing different types of materials. I think it gives them a lot of character. So for this one, I layered two tags and then I cluster a bunch of hearts and arrows and I put love what you do. I made my own tiny words and I printed it on sticker paper. For this tag, I layered the words love straight and in reverse and I overlapped it on the letter L and then I put the life we live. I love how it turned out. This one, I punch a big butterfly and several different shapes that I clustered together with the word believe. This one is a cute one that says love you always, and I use an arrow that I made also. And for this tag, I'm using that ticket that I made, and I'm going to show you how to make your own. They're super cool to decorate your projects and embellishments. I really like them. And for this prize ribbon, I'm using a lot of pink and shimmer here, and I think it turned out really cute. For this tag, I used half of that ticket, and then I layered it on the word I, and then the love on the heart in reverse, and I put an arrow. After the tip of the arrow, I'm gonna put the word you. And this one's my favorite. I stamp a typewriter and I put the word love and stay curious, and I use some gold trim and I layered a bunch of shapes in there and I turned out really cute. And for the last one, it says those who leave a trail of glitter are never forgotten. And as you know, I love glitter. So here is the tag that I made using the ticket, and I'm going to show you now how to make it. I'm going to be using the stamp set from Inka Dinka Doo. It's an old stamp set and it's called Tickets and Tags. And I'm going to be using one of the tickets. It has two different ones on different sizes. I'm going to use a bigger one to kind of give me an idea of the size of my ticket. You don't need to have a ticket specific stamp set, as I'm going to show you farther along, so keep watching. Each ticket is going to be 2 3/8 by 1 3/8. And I'll be using 8.5 by 11 inches cardstock. Since I'm using a small scoring board, I'm going to score it on the short side, on the 8.5, and I'm going to score 1 3/8. Then I'm going to turn my cardstock around and I'm going to start scoring every 2 3/8 inches to create my tickets. I'm going to have to move my cardstock around since my scoring board is really small. If I would have been using the bigger one, I would have scored the 1 3/8 on the longer side, the 11 inches side, and that would have given me more tickets. But this is good. So now we're going to trim along that score line there, and this is going to give us our strip. I'll be using a 1/4 inch circle punch from EK Success, but you can use any small circle punch that you have. You can even use a crocodile. And now we're going to punch on the corner here of our strip, and we're going to punch 1/4 of that circle so we can get the ticket shape. So then we turn it around and score again just 1/4 of that circle. And as you can see, it's starting to look like a ticket already. Now I'm going to turn around my cardstock and using the score line, I'm going to cut 1/2 circle. So I'm going to use the score line as a guide and I'm going to cut 1/2 circle. And here's our first ticket. So keep doing that to the rest of the strip. Cut 1/2 circle using the score line as a guide. And I like this punch from EK Success because it has a little line there and I can use that to align it with my score line. I'm going to be using a Martha Stewart stamping block that has little foam legs, and it's going to allow me to position my stamp whatever I wanted. So we're going to have here our first sticket. Doesn't it look great? I love it. So now grab your circle bunch again, and we're going to bunch in the middle of the strip right there. Use the scoring line as a guide, and this is going to give us a more realistic look. Doesn't it look great already? And now we're going to grab some foam board. You can find this at any craft stores like Joann's, Michael's. You can even find it at the Dollar Tree store and school supply stores. And we're going to start poking little holes right by the score lines. As you can see here, it gives it a verder look. It looks so real. So keep poking holes all along the score lines through your ticket strip. And you're going to see it's starting to look almost perfect. I love it. If you fold it, it really looks like one of those circus ticket strips. I really like it. So now I'm going to show you. I'm going to be stamping here the rest of my strip. And this stamp image here was not very good, so I finished it with my pen, and it looks good now. I am going to stamp the other image that says I love you, and it has a date and a number in there. It looks so cool. And I'm going to partially stamp the half of a ticket that remains. I split my first ticket, and you can see here it has half of those punch holes in there, and it looks so realistic. I'm going to show you now, you don't need to have a specific ticket stamp set. You can use any stamp set that fits your ticket. So I'm going to be using the Mama Elephant Smitten stamp set, and I'm going to stamp this sentiment that says, "Smile, it looks good on you." I started with a pen, but the lines were too thin, so I'm going to use an EK Success journaling pen that is going to give me the look of a stamped image. And I'm going to trace around here and give it the shape of a ticket. So as you can see here, you don't need to have a ticket-specific stamp set for it. Now I'm going to fill in my tickets so they look more like they belong. You can doodle on them, just fill them as much as you can, and they will look as they're part of the ticket. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked my video. If you did, don't forget, click the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you back here soon for another video. Bye bye.